Is that you said that? God. 4:24. Ephesians 4:24. Put on your new nature. Created to be what? Now you don't answer. True righteousness and holiness. So stop telling lies. Hello? Now you may say, you may not be telling lies. So God tells you, stop telling lies. You know, there's something we call white collar lies. Stop telling lies. Let us tell our neighbors the truth, for we are all part of the same body. And don't sin by letting anger control you. Hey, don't sin by what?
Letting anger control you.
If you see and allow anger to control you, here, let me see your hands up. God bless you. As you are faithful, you are delivered in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That old nature is defeated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As you are faithful, anger shall not control your life again in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But God shall control you. That is part of telling lies. Your anger is there now, you say it's not there. See? Stop telling lies. Can you see? God will help us.
Amen.
And don't sin by letting anger control you. Don't let the sun go down while you are still angry. For anger gives a foothold to the devil. Can you see? 5 days you are still keeping malice in the same house. It happened between us, one and one. One will face inside, and the other one, then the gap will be in between them. Some will sit at the edge, sleep at the edge of the bed like this. The other one will sit at the edge of the bed. When he's waking up, he'll present and sleep. After you are talking about two dress, then you know. Ha! You know you are here. Another happened. Someone is waiting who is going to get home first. I go to. Can you see? Even when that is on, you don't even have peace. You don't have joy. Your own world will become a stranger. You cannot go sit down. It's in the room I discuss. Isn't that the devil?
Yes.
Devil robbed you of your bedroom, robbed you of your living room, robbed you of your kitchen. You get to the kitchen, you run your poop. So that he's not going to meet you in the kitchen. Am I preaching?
Yes, you are.
If it is affecting you, let me see your hands up. God bless you, sir. So after the poop, even when your car has problem, because you are not in a good dance with your spouse, you cannot hook up. And devil knows how to punish. Maybe if you lost your key and he has his.
Yes,
and you cannot come. Because of the prayer, what will I say? I'm not going to let you know that I'm going through this problem. And then. Can you see? We punish ourselves. It's the devil. Whenever you allow the anger to go overnight, you are creating a foundation for the devil to build up. So little things. As time goes on, you don't even know what started the quarrel. Because he has mounted up. And then you ask, what causes the problem initially? Then you look at it. Something does happen. What is that something? None of you can remember. Say, devil, you are disgraced. Say, devil, you are disgraced. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
You say, you are a thief. Who is stealing? Hello? They cannot test you with anything. You can steal anything. People from the other. Do you think I'm mistaken here, put $100 here? Do you think it's not to remain?
Yeah.
Yes.
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 No.
Let me tell you, a if I have tested it before, it did not read me. Why? Who is Stevie? You know, it's like a spirit. No, we know. Thank you, who know deep. We have a lot of people in church. Stealing. He said, quit. Quit stealing. You steal your husband's money. Put money in the pocket. Let me tell you, just say $20. Right, guys. Tell him you took $20. Not just snatch. I mean, no, you got your husband's wallet. You got your husband's wallet. So she has a lot of money like this? I don't know. Whether you don't have to start with us, let me say, God, she's not going to know. Hello. You know what I'm talking about. If you are 450 of that, let me see your hands up. God bless you, man. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Those are sinner thieves. You know when we are measuring thieves, there's no class. It's not brother, it's a thief. When you take anything that does not belong to you, it's what? Is what? God will forgive. Praise God. So instead, use your hands for good hard work and then give demonstrate to others in need. Don't use vile or abusive language. Let everything you say be good and helpful so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. God will change us.
Amen.
Because Christ in us is the hope of glory. Yes. God uses his word, his people, and circumstances to reshape us. God can use a problem to reshape our life. Paul said, I was in need. I know how to manage both, to live in need and to live in abundance. I know how to manage because I'll be gay. Now, when you have been poor, and God brought you out of that level, when you see those who are in need, you will not close your eyes. Because you have been there, you know how it works. You want to go out to any length to help other people. If you have been sick and you know how painful it is, you know how to pray for those people that are sick. God's word provide the truth. We need to grow. God's people provide the support. We need to grow. And circumstances provide the environment. We need to practice Christ-likeness. You cannot practice Christ-likeness in your room without nobody there. Hello?
Yes.
You can only practice it in the church. When someone says, oh, you say, I'm sorry, God bless you. Even when you sit in a place and someone does God here, take your Bible, put it somewhere and sit down there. I was once sitting there, don't you know? Can't you see? I'm not blind. I'm told me in the quiet room. What do you do?